Hey guys, welcome back. If you are new to the channel, welcome. I'm Meg. If you have been here before or are a returning subscriber, then welcome back. I don't know, today I was thinking, I was loving this makeup so much that I thought, you know what, let's not make just one video using that makeup, but let's make two. So today I thought, what are some of the things that I have been wanting to talk about? Or maybe a success story or something like that. And I was thinking, you know what? Maybe I should tell them about how I rehabilitated myself and curbed my shopping addiction. Now, I know I've done a few videos similar to this, or I've spoken about stuff that I have done in order for me to stop buying so much makeup and being a hoarder and be a more conscious consumer. But there are a few things that I have actually done as well that I think would be helpful for some of you guys if you are looking for tips on how to do it. Now, if you have been a follower of mine for a while, you know that I have had a large collection of makeup, not as large as other YouTubers, but large nonetheless for a single person who is not even a makeup artist. So yeah, I did have a lot of a big collection, and I have managed to downsize to probably half, if not a quarter, of what I used to have. And I'll tell you some of the things that I have done to do that. One of which is to stop buying makeup altogether. And when I say that, I don't mean like I've completely stopped or anything. I have been purchasing like items here and there, but not as much as I used to. And what I've done is really to look at my collection, look at what I have, look at what I have been using, look at what I have not been using, not have been reaching out for, and realize the things that I actually like in my collection and the ones that I don't. So having said that, now every time I look at a makeup or every time I watch a YouTube review or a first impression or a haul, I think to myself, do I really need that? Is that really something that I want in my collection? Is it something that I am going to use? And what I have started doing is that whenever I see something like that, I would read a lot of reviews, I would watch a lot more reviews. In the past, that would cause me to actually impulse buy on these things. But what I have done now is become more analytical of my purchases. Especially since, you know, I've moved a couple of times and it was very, very difficult to transport all of that makeup. Especially since I'm not just moving cities or like simple moving houses in the same state. I'm moving countries. So it's a lot more difficult than just, you know, going to the next street or something like that. So it's something that I have been very considerate about. So whenever I look at a new release, I think to myself, do I really need it? Is it something that I really want or need in my collection? Like, for example, I don't know if you have already seen my to buy or not to buy video last time where I talked about the Patrick Star collection with MAC, though specifically the color or the palettes Miso Chic and Miso Fleek. I don't know if you've seen that video, but I did say that I was very interested in it. But then after watching some reviews and looking at the collection itself, I thought to myself, look, the lipstick there looks very similar to a lot of my lipsticks that are already in my collection, which are very nude lipsticks, very wearable lipsticks. Second, lip gloss. I don't really use lip gloss. I'm not a very big fan of lip gloss, so I don't think I will have much use out of that. And then the next one were it was the duo. I was specifically keen on the Miso Chic, which was sort of like his tribute to Mama Star. And that came with a blush duo that looked more like a bronzer and a like a neutral toned kind of peachy blush. And I look at my blush collection and you know what? I've got myself covered with that. With all of them, even just with my MAC blushes, I think I've got shades that are very, very similar to that. But then I also have a good collection of NARS blushes that I think would cover those as well. So I was thinking, you know what? I don't really need that. And then the palette that came in there was a palette that had a really bright blue and lots of pinks, and there was a palette that had the purples. And you know what? I have similar colors in my collection. In fact, I created this look based off of those two palettes, and I was thinking to myself, you know what, I've been wanting those colors, but guess what, I have them in my collection, I don't have to buy them. So something like that. I've really looked into what I already have and what I can duplicate, because granted, the packaging of that is very, very attractive, it's so beautiful, I really, really wanted it. But I thought to myself, $49.50, not a bad deal considering all the things that you get in there. Like a MAC lipstick is already $17, you know, and a blush is like $26, I think. So like right then and there, you would have already gotten your money back from that. But then I think to myself, do I really need to add that into my collection? It's just going to add up to the stuff that I have to use up, and I probably wouldn't want to use it up because it's so pretty. So it's not a practical purchase for me, and I decided I'm not gonna buy it because, you know, I got the shades right here on my face right now, right? The other thing that I really think about, and I've done multiple times in the last year, is to declutter my social media. Not just the YouTubers that I follow, but even Instagram. I do have an Instagram account called The Granny Lifestyle, which is where I post more of my social media brand, or how do I say it? The things that I want people who don't necessarily know me to see. Then I have my personal Instagram account, which is Meg B. Morrison. So anyway, in The Granny Lifestyle, I follow Dupe That and Trend Mood just to keep me updated on what's coming out, because I do make videos about whether or not I will buy products. That's the only reason why I follow them. It is not to get inspiration on what I need to buy. It is just to keep myself updated with the things that are coming out. And oh my god, I just realized that I am able to film a to buy or not to buy video every week because of the amount of releases that companies make. And I'm like, what? No. Anyways, having said that, so I have decluttered my social media, and I really just watch. I haven't been watching hauls. Like, right now, YouTube is inundated with Sephora VIB sale hauls, and I haven't been watching any of those because I'm thinking to myself, holy shit, that's a lot of makeup, and you already have a lot of makeup. I'm like, look, no judgments here. You do you. You spend your money, you do whatever you want with it, but it's not something that I want to do at this point in my life. And I do not want to be influenced by stuff that I know I might already have or will not be using anyway. So I've stopped doing that. I've actually been watching a lot more entertainment videos, like Stephen Colbert, James Corden, Jimmy Fallon, you know, all of those kinds of videos on YouTube, not necessarily just beauty. I've ventured into other ones like fashion, DIYs and stuff like that. I have not concentrated on beauty videos because honestly, I have enough for a lifetime and I will never be able to use it all up. So there you go. So that's numbers two of the things that I have done. The second thing that I've done, and this is quite new to me, is that every time I think I want to purchase a makeup product, not only do I like wait maybe 3 to 5 days before I decide if I actually really want it, but if I decide that I don't want it, the amount that I would have set aside to purchase that product, I've put into my savings account. So that I see my account growing and my makeup collection shrinking, which is really cool. And I saw this, I read about it in a Facebook group with Makeup Use Up, which is by LS. Yeah. So I'm part of that group, and we sort of encourage each other to buy only what you need, or more like repurchases of things that you've used up, and to use up the products that you already have. And one of the ladies on there said that that's what she has done. She's like opened up an online account that where she puts in the money that would have gone into purchasing makeup into that account and see it grow. And that's really a good motivation as well for those of us who are struggling, especially if you are in debt because of so much makeup hoarding, then perhaps this is something that you should look at. Instead of buying that product that you think you need in your life, but you really don't, put that money towards your online savings account and see that money grow into sort of your investment fund. Okay, I'm not saying you shouldn't buy any more makeup or whatever it is, because like I said, you do you, do whatever you want with your money. It's just that for me, when I read that, I thought genius. That is so genius. Every time I think I want to buy a product, and every time I realize that, you know what, no, I'm not gonna buy that product, instead of putting that money towards buying that makeup or that skincare or whatever beauty product it is, I put it into my savings account and watch that money grow. Right. The other thing that I have been doing, because especially living in Australia, you can shop by just tapping your card or sometimes even just your phone and not actually see the money come out of your account. And I realized that with me doing that, I'm like, I don't have any control. And because I don't see the actual money coming out of my wallet and into the hands of the cashier, I find it so easy to just not realize how much money I'm spending on stuff that I don't need. Okay, so what I have started doing in the beginning of the year was actually to take out cash, put it in my wallet, and that will be my spending money for the week. Okay, obviously this isn't going to include like money for rent or money for groceries and stuff like that, or for transport. This is just spending money, like luxury money. And I'll take out like maybe $100 Australian dollars in a week. And that's my spending money. And I find that it is a deterrent for me to be purchasing stuff that I don't need, because I actually see the money coming out of my wallet into my hands and onto the hands of somebody else. And then I look at the things that are in my basket and I think to myself, do I really need those things? Am I really willing to part with my $100 or whatever amount it is, under $100, for something like that? Like, if I look at a t-shirt and I wanna buy it, and I think to myself, wait, this is gonna take out like $6 or $7 out of my $100 weekly budget. Do I really need this? And it keeps me thinking, and I just like leave it behind. If I'm still keen on it after 3 or 5 days of thinking about it, then I'll come back for it. If it's there, then it's meant to be mine. If it's been already purchased by somebody else, then it just wasn't meant to be. That's how I think about it. And it comes out really, really well in that sense, because I feel like if I am holding the money, I am more reluctant to spend it on frivolous things. So that's what I've been doing from the beginning of the year, and I've been quite successful in maintaining that budget. For sometimes I don't even spend the $100 in that week, because I think to myself, you know what, I'm just going to roll this over to the next week or put it into my savings account for something that I would really want to purchase or probably would really need. And then it creates for me also an emergency fund, so just in case something happens and let's say my health insurance doesn't cover it or anything like that, then I have that emergency fund. Like when I had my knee injury and I had to get an MRI, which was $300, okay? And that's not covered by Medicare or by my private health insurance, and I had to pay for it from my pocket. And it was a good thing that I did have saved up money when that happened, because I wouldn't know where to get that $300 if I didn't have that emergency fund. So things like this make me realize how important it is for me to actually look at my spending, look at what I use my money for. And also, like right now, I am here in Vietnam and I'm having some issues returning to Australia because of some visa restrictions. And I'm glad that I've got some money saved up, because I wouldn't know what to do if I was jobless instantly. You know, I still have a job waiting for me back in Australia, don't get me wrong. And my team has been very, very good to me. But like what I'm saying, if you lose your job in an instant, you know, if you get fired or if the company closes down and you don't have enough savings to tide you through the days that you are unemployed, what are you going to do? Right? So those things that creep into my mind, I know it's a very adulting kind of thing, but it actually makes me think like, you know what, I need to be a little bit more responsible with my spending and a little bit more responsible with my saving. So yeah, I hope you guys found some useful tips in this video. And if you have your own tips that you want to share with the rest of our community, then please leave them in the comment section down below on how you curb your spending and your makeup addiction. Thank you very much for watching, and I hope to enjoy this. If you did, do give me a thumbs up. Subscribe if you haven't already, and click on that notification button so that you know whenever I upload videos. I'll see you in the next video. Thanks very much for watching. Bye.